Good morning, class 12th. Welcome to your class of English, wherein we are continuing with our chapter, The Enemy. And in the previous session that we did, what we noticed was that after the seventh day, two things happened. And one was that the servants left, and the other thing was that the General Takima had sent a message for Dr. Sadao because he wasn't keeping well. And we came to know that the messenger who had come had told that the general is in pain and he needed the assistance of Dr. Sadao. And here we saw that the kind of fear that was felt by Hannah, you know, it just couldn't be described. And she was so exhausted by fear and she was so scared because she thought that their secret was out. Now, when Sadao meets the general and he tells him everything, we see a very, very selfish side of General Takima. And we see that this man is so absorbed with his own things, with his own personal agendas, that he is least bothered that what is happening or what is not happening. All he knows is that if he is not keeping well, he would need Dr. Sadao's assistance, his medical treatment, and therefore he could not afford anything to happen to Dr. Sadao. Okay, so what happens now? We see on this page a very, very selfish General Takima. And then we come to page number 41. We see that after Dr. Sadao has told everything to General Takima, he says that there is one solution of this problem, and that is that he will be sending his own private assassins. Okay? People who would murder in the want of money. And so General Takima had his own assassins, and these assassins were very, very highly trained. They knew the trick of inward bleeding, which meant that if they would kill Tom, that is the American prisoner of war, it would not involve bloodshed, it would not involve any kind of hassle, but they would do it in such a way that he would bleed, you know, within, and he would die. And then Sadao says, if you like, I can even have them remove the body. So, General Takima said. So, Sadao was quite happy about it because he thought that it would be best. And that's the only thing that could have been sensibly done in this situation, because he had to think about himself. And more than that, he was now worried about Hannah. Right? And why we know this? Because here when Hannah is really scared, you know, he says that I must get rid of this man for your sake. So it was the worry of Hannah's mental peace was bothering him a lot. So this is the meeting that takes place between Dr. Sadao and General Takima. And then he left the general's presence then and went home thinking over the plan. So what is the plan, my dear children? The plan is that private assassins will be sent by General Takima to the house of Dr. Sadao. They will kill Tom with the trick of inward bleeding, and they will also remove the body. Or what will Hannah think? Hannah ko lagega ki apparently Tom haan se khud chala gaya. Okay, so now we begin with today's session. In this way, the whole thing would be taken out of his hands. Whose hands? Sadao's hands. He would tell Hannah nothing, since she would be timid at the idea of assassins in the house. And he decides that he is not going to tell Hannah anything, because as a woman, she will not be very, very happy of having assassins in the house. And yet certainly, such persons were essential in an absolute state such as Japan was. How else could rulers deal with those who opposed them? So now Sadao is saying that for people like General Takima, it was important to have even such kind of people around him. What kind of people? The assassins. Because in an absolute state wherein General Takima was taking care of everything, he would have to definitely deal with a lot of people who would be opposing them. And what is the best way of, you know, dealing with opposition is to silence it completely. So that's how these assassins were very much there with General Takima. He refused to allow anything but reason to be the atmosphere of his mind as he went into the room where the American was in bed. And Sadao did not think of anything else. He is saying he only allowed reason to be in his mind. That means here Sadao is being very, very practical at the idea of the assassins and everything. So reasoning, usne sirf practical reasoning rakhi apne dimag mein as he went in the room where the American was in bed. But as he opened the door, to his surprise, he found the young man out of bed and preparing to go into garden. Ab jaise he went into Tom's room where this man was kept, he saw that this boy Tom was not in his bed, but he was getting ready to go into the garden. That's what the plan was. "What is this?" he explained. "Who gave you permission to leave your room?" "I am not used to waiting for permission," Tom said gaily. So Sadao ne Tom se pucha, "What is this? Who gave you the permission to get out of the room?" So he said that, "I am not used to of taking permissions." And then Tom says, "Gosh, I feel pretty good again. But will the muscles on this side always feel stiff?" So now this is apparently going to be the first conversation between, a lengthy conversation between Dr. Sadao and Tom. And now since Tom is recovering, he's doing really good in terms of his medical recovery, his recovery from the surgery. So Tom says that, "I am feeling so good." And then he's talking to Sadao and he says, "Will the muscles on this side always feel stiff?" He's feeling some stiffness in those muscles on the right side, on the lower back where he was shot. So now this is Sadao's line, okay? "Is it so?" Sadao inquired, surprised. He forgot all else. Aur jaise hi Tom ne ye bola ki bhai yahan mujhe stiffness feel ho rahi hai, so the doctor in Sadao, you know, came out and took over him completely. Aur wo sab bhool gaya ki wo Tom se gussa ho raha tha ya jo bhi tha, and he forgot everything else. Aur wo apne aap se bolta hai, "Now I thought I had provided against that." Provided against that matlab against the stiffness, matlab usne kuch medication diya tha, he murmured. He lifted the edge of the man's shirt at the healing, aur usne वहां से उसका शर्ट ऊपर करा जहां पे उस स्कार था, और वो क्या बोलता है, "मसाज मे डू इट ही सेड इफ एक्सरसाइज डज नॉट." कहता है मसाजिंग से शायद ये स्टिफनेस दूर हो जाएगी अगर एक्सरसाइज से ठीक नहीं हुई. "इट वोंट बॉदर मी मच," द यंग मैन सेड. टॉम ने बोला कि कोई बात नहीं, इवन इफ द स्टिफनेस इज देयर, इट्स नॉट गोइंग टू बॉदर मी दैट मच. दिस इज वॉट ही सेड. His young face was gaunt under the stubbly blonde beard. And now what do we see? We see that this is a young boy, okay? Barely 20, 21, this American sailor. So his young face was gaunt, gaunt as in angular, under the stubbly blonde beard. Stubbly is matlab chota chota, coarse. Beard, you know, okay? "Sir, doctor, I have got something I want to say to you. If I hadn't met a Jap like you, well, I wouldn't be alive today. I know that." और टॉम क्या कहता है डॉक्टर सदाओ से, कहता है कि अगर मुझे आपके जैसा जापानीज नहीं मिला होता तो I wouldn't have been alive today. सदाओ bowed, but he could not speak. "Sure, I know that," Tom went on warmly, his big thin hands gripping a chair were white at the knuckles. "I guess if all the Japs were like you, there wouldn't have been a war." Aur Tom kehta hai ki nahi, mujhe acche se pata hai ki if my life has been saved, it has only been because of you. And then such an important thing he says, my dear children, please pay attention. He says that if all the Japanese were like you, then there wouldn't have been a war between America and Japan. So this is a very short conversation, a very short dialogue taking place between Tom and Dr. Sadao, wherein first Tom starts telling about the stiffness in his muscles close to the scar, And then we have Tom, who is thanking Dr. Sadao for everything that he has done for him. Okay. Perhaps Sadao said with difficulty, and now I think you had better go back to bed. तो जब वो बोलता है कि अगर सारे जापानीज आपके जैसे होते तो लड़ाई नहीं होती, तो वो कहता है हाँ maybe, I'm not sure. And then he says, now I think you had better go back to bed. You should be sleeping. He helped the boy back into bed and then bowed. Good night, he said. अब this is the first night when Sadao has come back from General Takima's place. So today the assassins should come as per the commitment made by General Takima. तो क्या हुआ? Sadao slept badly that night. He couldn't sleep, he didn't have a sound sleep. Time and again, he woke, thinking he heard the rustling of footsteps, the sound of a twig broken or a stone displaced in the garden. और उसको बार 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 ऐसा लग रहा था Sadao को कि maybe there is some kind of noise, कोई अंदर आ रहा है, footsteps हैं, कोई stone गिरा garden में, and things like that. Okay, and then he was in his mind, he was thinking कि maybe these are the kind of noises which are made when men like the assassins, they might carry a heavy burden, like Tom for instance. Okay. The next morning he made the excuse to go first into the guest room. अब क्या हुआ? सुबह हो गई और उसको लगा कि वो ही उसी को पहले अंदर जाना चाहिए. If the American were gone, he then could simply tell Hannah that so the general had directed. और उसको लगा कि अगर American नहीं होगा तो वो Hannah को बिल्कुल वैसे ही बता देगा जैसा general ने उसको बोला था. But when he opened the door, he saw at once that there on the pillow was a shaggy blonde head. But क्या हुआ? जैसे ही वो रूम में घुसा उसने देखा कि पिलो पे there was this blonde head. Blonde head refers to the golden hair of Tom. And it was shaggy, it was unkempt. He could hear the peaceful breathing of sleep and close the door again quietly. उसने उसकी peaceful breathing सुनी और उसने चुपचाप दरवाजा बंद कर दिया. He is asleep, he told Hannah. He is almost well to sleep like that. कहता है कि बिल्कुल अब ठीक है इसकी तबीयत. He has recovered and now he is sleeping so peacefully because he is recovered. Now a very very important question comes from Hannah, something that she has been repeating over and over again. What shall we do with him? Hannah whispered her old refrain. और हैना ने वही अपनी पुरानी बात फिर से पूछी कि भाई हमें इसका करना क्या है, हम इसका क्या करेंगे? किसका? टॉम का. Sadao shook his head. I must decide in a day or two, he promised. अब Sadao तो बात करे आया ना जनरल Takima से, अब तो उसको बस वेट करना है कि द assassins विल कम एंड दे विल किल टॉम. सो द फर्स्ट नाइट हैज गॉन इन वेन, नाउ कम्स द सेकेंड वन. बट सर्टनली ही थॉट द सेकेंड नाइट मस्ट बी द नाइट. उसको लगा कि हाँ आज ही की रात जो है सेकेंड नाइट होगी वेर इन द प्राइवेट असैसिन्स आर गोइंग टू कम टू द हाउस. और उस रात कैसा मौसम था? देयर रोज अ विंड दैट नाइट, खूब तेज हवा चली. एंड ही लिसन टू द साउंड ऑफ बेंडिंग बोज एंड विस्लिंग पार्टीशंस. उसको सुनाई पड़ रही थी आवाज, बेंडिंग बोज मतलब ब्रांचेज और डालियां. ओके. हैना वोक टू. Ought we not to go and close the sick man's partition? She asked. बोली अरे क्या हमको जाकर के उसका पार्टीशन नहीं बंद करना चाहिए जो गार्डन की तरफ खुलता है, क्योंकि इतनी तेज हवा चल रही है. तो Sadao ने क्या कहा? No, Sadao said. He is able now to do it for himself. Sadao ने कहा वो बिल्कुल ठीक है, उसे पार्टीशन बंद करना होगा तो वो खुद पार्टीशन बंद कर लेगा. But the next morning the American was still there. Second night also nothing happened and the American was very much alive. Then the third night, of course, must be the night. The wind changed to quiet rain and the garden was full of the sound of dripping eaves and running springs. अब तीसरी नाइट आ गई. Sadao को लगा आज तो वो assassins आएंगे ही आएंगे. और उस रात खूब बारिश हो रही थी. Sadao slept a little better, but he woke at the sound of a crash and leaped to his feet. But suddenly एक crashing की आवाज आई और Sadao एकदम खड़ा हो गया. What was that? Hannah cried. The baby woke at her voice and began to wail as in cry. I must go and see. Hannah बोली मैं देखकर क्या आती हूँ. But he held her and would not let her move. But Sadao ने उसको नहीं जाने दिया. उसको लगा कि अभी नहीं जाने दे सकता, ये जरूर assassins आ गए हैं और वो लोग अपना काम कर रहे हैं. Sadao, She cried, "What is the matter with you?" "Don't go," he muttered, "don't go." तो उसने कहा, "Sit down, what is the matter? Why are you so scared?" तो वो बोलता है कि नहीं, don't go. His terror infected her. और जो टेरर सदाओ के फेस पे था, जो उसके जो वो फील कर रहा था, इट सॉर्ट ऑफ इन्फेक्टेड हैना एज वेल एंड शी स्टूड ब्रेथलेस वेटिंग. देयर वाज ओनली साइलेंस. टुगेदर दे क्रेप्ट बैक इनटू द बेड, द बेबी बिटवीन देम. और कुछ देर बाद क्या हुआ, दे क्रेप्ट बैक इनटू द बेड एंड द बेबी वॉज स्लीपिंग बिटवीन देम. सो फर्स्ट नाइट गॉन, सेकेंड नाइट गॉन एंड द थर्ड नाइट गॉन. अब तक कुछ नहीं हुआ है. Okay, the assassins have not come. Yet, when he opened the door of the guest room in the morning, there was the young man. He was very gay and had already washed and was now on his feet. He was looking very happy and joyful, and he had already taken a shower and he was standing. He had asked for a razor yesterday. Razor usne kal manga tha. So apparently he has also shaved himself and had shaved himself today. There was a faint color in his cheeks. And slowly and steadily as his health was improving, uske cheeks mein bhi kya tha? Ek faint coloring thi. Okay? I am well, he said joyously. Sadao drew his kimono round his weary body. Now, kimonos are very traditional Japanese dresses, so you can always Google them. He decided suddenly, go through another night. तो सदाओ ने अपना kimono पहना और उसको लगा कि मैं एक और रात ऐसे परेशान होकर नहीं काट सकता. Three nights have gone. It was not that he cared for this young man's life. No. सिंपली इट वॉज नॉट वर्थ द स्ट्रेन. कहता मुझे उसकी कोई चिंता नहीं है कि मैं उसके लिए जाग रहा हूं. कह रहा बट इस आदमी के लिए जंगला इज नॉट वर्थ द स्ट्रेन. कोई इतनी बड़ी बात नहीं कि इसके लिए इतना बड़ा सैक्रीफाइस करूं. यू आर वेल, सदाओ अग्रीड. नाउ सदाओ इज टॉकिंग टू टॉम. ही लोअर्ड हिज वॉइस. यू आर सो वेल दैट आई थिंक इफ आई पुट माई बोट ऑन द शोर टू नाइट with food and extra clothing in it, you might be able to row to that little island not far from the coast. अब सदाओ कहता है तुम ठीक हो और इतने ठीक हो कि अगर मैं तुम्हें अपनी बोट दे दूं, उसमें कुछ खाना वाना पानी वानी तुम्हें रख के दे दूं, तुम उस बोट से वो सामले आइलैंड्स पे जा सकते हो which are not very far from the coast. It is so near the coast that it has not been worth fortifying. और कहता है वो आइलैंड इतना कोस्ट के इतना पास है कि अब तक उस पर कोई डिफेंस लगाने की जरूरत ही नहीं पड़ी है. Nobody lives on it. उस आइलैंड पे कोई नहीं रहता. क्यों? Because in the storm it is submerged. क्योंकि अगर तूफान आता है तो ये आइलैंड पानी में सबमर्ज हो जाता है. But this is not the season of storm. But right now it is not the season of storm over there. You could live there until you saw a Korean fishing boat pass by. Now see children, please understand. This is how Sadao is helping Tom. कहता है मैं तुम्हें बोट दे दूंगा, आई गिव यू फूड वाटर एंड एवरी थिंग. तुम वहां आइलैंड पे चले जाना एंड यू बी देयर और वहां पे क्या होगा, एक कोरियन फिशिंग बोट आएगी. ठीक है, और तुम जैसे ही वो कोरियन फिशिंग बोट आएगी, नाउ कोरियंस एंड अमेरिकन्स आर फ्रेंड. ओके, तो अगर कोई कोरियन शिपिंग बोट आती है तो टॉम उसमें हेल्प ले सकता है. दे पास क्वाइट नियर द आइलैंड. दे पास क्या है, द Korean fishing boats. The young man stared at him or Tom was surprised and he is looking at Dr. Sadao. और वो क्या बोलता है, Do I have to? He asked. ये बहुत important statement है, बहुत ज्यादा. वो पूछता है कि क्या मुझे ऐसा करना जरूरी है, क्या करना जरूरी है कि आप मुझे बोट दें और मुझे यहां से निकालें. Why is he saying that? Why is Tom saying so? So Tom is saying all this because he feels so safe in their house. Tom ko lagta hai ki agar main yahan se kahin bahar jaunga to my life will be in danger. There is a continuous threat. To wo kehta hai ki kya mera jana zaruri hai? Do I have to go? I think, Sadao said gently. Sadao ne kaha ki haan, tumhe jana padega. Aur wo aage kya bolta hai? You understand? It is not hidden that you are here. कहता है देखो ये बात छुपी हुई नहीं है कि तुम हमारे यहाँ पे रह रहे हो. Everybody knows about it. Everybody as in the servants and everyone. The young man nodded in perfect comprehension. Okay, he said simply. तो वो समझ गया इस बात को और बोला हाँ ठीक है, आप ठीक कह रहे हैं. So I'm going to go. Sadao did not see him again until evening. और उस दिन शाम तक Sadao की उससे मुलाकात नहीं हुई. As soon as it was dark, he had dragged the stout boat down to the shore, and in it he put food and bottled water that he had bought secretly during the day. और चुपचाप जब शाम को Sadao आया, उसने अपनी बोट को पुश करके वहां कोस्ट तक ले गया, उसमें वाटर फूड ये सारे अरेंजमेंट्स करे. ओके, एंड यू नो ही डिड इट वेरी वेरी सीक्रेटली, एज वेल एज टू क्विल्स ही हैड बॉट एट अ पॉन शॉप. सो प्लीज अंडरलाइन व्हाट ऑल डिड Sadao गिव हिम, फूड, बॉटल वाटर एंड ऑल्सो टू क्विल्स ही हैड बॉट एट अ पॉन शॉप. ओके, the boat he tied to a post in the water, for the tide was high. There was no moon, and he worked without a flashlight. और उसने उस boat को किससे, एक post से बांध दिया, क्योंकि water का tide बहुत high था और बिल्कुल भी रोशनी नहीं थी, तो बिल्कुल अंधेरा था. When he came back to the house, he entered as though he were just back from his work. और ये सब कुछ करने के बाद वो अपने घर ऐसे घुसा जैसे ऑफिस से सीधा घर ही आ रहा हो. And so Hannah knew nothing. और इस वजह से हैना को कुछ भी नहीं पता था. अब वो Sadao को कुछ बताती है. क्या? Yumi was here today, she said, as she served him supper. और उसने बताया कि Yumi आज घर आई थी. और एक इम्पोर्टेंट चीज हमें यहां पता लगती है Yumi हैना के बारे में. Though she was so modern, who? Hannah. Still she did not eat with him. बहुत पढ़ी लिखी थी, मॉडर्न थी, बट फिर भी Sadao के साथ बैठ के खाना नहीं खाती थी वो. Yumi cried over the baby. She went on with a sigh. She misses him so much. और वो बताती है कि Yumi आई थी and she was feeling very very bad and she was crying. तो Sadao बोलता है the servants will come back as soon as the foreigner is gone. कहता है जैसे ही foreigner चला जाएगा. Foreigner कौन है यहाँ पे बच्चे? Tom. He went into the guest room that night before he went to bed himself and checked carefully the American's temperature. उस दिन उसने खुद अमेरिकन का टेम्परेचर चेक करा. The state of the wound and his heart and pulse. Please underline these two, three things that I have mentioned here. Okay? So the first thing was temperature, one. Second thing, state of the wound. And third was his heart and pulse. The pulse was irregular, but that was perhaps because of excitement. The young man's pale lips were pressed together and his eyes burned. Only the scars on his neck were red. और वो कहता है कि उसने उसको चेक करा उसकी हेल्थ को. What did he do? He checked his temperature, he checked the state of the wound, and he checked his heart and pulse. So, and then once again Tom says, I realize you are saving my life again. और जब ये सब कुछ Sadao करने लग गए तो टॉम ने बोला कि I understand you are saving my life once again. Not at all, Sadao said. It is only inconvenient to have you here any longer. Sadao कहता नहीं नहीं कोई बात नहीं है, मैंने कोई तुम पे ऐसा एहसान नहीं करा है. It is just that तुमको यहाँ पे ज्यादा देर के लिए रखना बहुत परेशानी का सबब बनता जा रहा है. He had hesitated a good deal about giving the man a flashlight. Flashlight मतलब torch. अब Sadao ने सोचा था इसको torch दूं या ना दूं, but he had decided to give it to him after all. But फिर भी उसने उसको torch दे दी. It was a small one, his own, which he used at night when he was called. और छोटी सी एक torch थी और वो वही torch थी, वही flashlight थी, वो जो रात में use करता था अगर Sadao को बुलाया जाता था for some reason. In this paragraph now, as you can see, I have written here, instructions by Sadao to Tom. Now, Sadao has given a boat full of food, water and two blankets to Tom. He has checked his vitals and now he wants Tom to take the boat and to escape. But यहाँ पे अब वो कुछ instructions दे रहा है. Please be very careful. If your food runs out before you catch a boat, he said, signal me two flashes. उसने उसको flashlight दी थी. कहता है अगर तुम्हारा खाना खत्म हो जाए तुम्हारी बोट मिलने से पहले, कौन सी बोट? कोरियन बोट. तो मुझे दो बार टॉर्च फ्लैश करना. एट द सेम इंस्टेंट द सन ड्रॉप्स ओवर द होराइजन. कहता है ठीक उसी वक्त जब सूरज बिल्कुल डूब रहा होता है. डू नॉट सिग्नल इन द डार्कनेस फॉर इट विल बी सीन. कहता है रात में सिग्नल मत करना क्योंकि रात में सिग्नल करोगे तो वो दिखेगा. इफ यू आर ऑल राइट बट स्टिल देयर सिग्नल मी वंस. कंडीशन नंबर टू कहता है अगर तुम वहां पे हो, खाना भी है और तुम भी बिल्कुल ठीक हो तो सिर्फ एक सिग्नल देना. यू विल फाइंड फ्रेश फिश इजी टू कैच बट यू मस्ट ईट. ओके द यंग मैन ब्रीथ्ड. तो वो कहता है कि यू विल फाइंड फ्रेश फिश इजी टू कैच बट यू मस्ट ईट देम रॉ. वो फिश कैसी खानी पड़ेगी? कच्ची खानी पड़ेगी, रॉ खानी पड़ेगी, क्योंकि आप आग नहीं जला सकते. अ फायर वुड बी सीन. अगर आपने किसी ऐसे आइलैंड पे काम करा या अपनी प्रेजेंस को फील कराया सो यू विल बी गेट कॉट. सो दीज वर द इंस्ट्रक्शंस गिवन बाय सदाओ टू टॉम. ही वॉज ड्रेस्ड नाउ इन द जैपनीज क्लोथ्स विच सदाओ हैड गिवन हिम. हु इज ड्रेस्ड? व्हाट्स हिज नेम? टॉम. So, Tom was dressed in the Japanese clothes which Sadao had given him, and at the last moment, Sadao wrapped a black cloth around his blonde head. और उसको Japanese traditional clothes दिए ताकि वो blended रहे बिल्कुल surroundings में. और most importantly, उसने एक black कपड़ा दिया ताकि वो उसको अपने blonde hair पे बांध सके, वरना blonde बाल चमकेंगे दूर से. Now, Sadao said, और Sadao ने उसको तैयार करा जाने के लिए. The young American, who is this young American? Tom. The young American, without a word, shook Sadao's hand warmly and then walked quietly well across the floor and down the step into the darkness of the garden. और वो वहां से उतर गया. Once, twice, Sadao saw his light flash to find his way, but that would not be suspected. He waited until from the shore there was one more flash. Then he closed the partition. And that night he slept. और इस तरीके से क्या हुआ? सदाओ ने escape कराया. किसको escape कराया? टॉम को escape कराया, क्योंकि वो इस चीज को नहीं bear कर पा रहा था कि पिछले तीन दिन से he has been unable to sleep, and it's only because of the thought of assassins in the house. So the best way out is to enable the man to escape. ठीक? अब क्या हुआ? टॉम हैज एस्केप्ड. अब यहां पे इधर वेर आई एम पुटिंग दिस हैशटैग. असैसिन्स नहीं आए हैं जनरल टाकीमा के. अब सदाओ ने ये बात खुद जाके जनरल टाकीमा को बताई है कि वो भाग गया है. कौन भाग गया है? टॉम. तो अब जनरल टाकीमा के रिस्पॉन्सेज हैं ये. यू सी द मैन एस्केप्ड, द जनरल आस्क्ड फेंटली. और क्या हुआ था? ही हैड बीन ऑपरेटेड अपॉन अ वीक बिफोर. पिछले ही हफ्ते डॉक्टर टाकीमा का, जनरल टाकीमा का सर्जरी हुआ है. एन इमरजेंसी ऑपरेशन टू विच सदाओ हैड बीन कॉल्ड इन द नाइट. देयर वाज एन इमरजेंसी ऑपरेशन. फॉर 12 आवर्स सदाओ हैड नॉट बीन श्योर दैट जनरल वुड लिव. 12 घंटे तक कोई श्योरिटी नहीं थी कि जनरल जिएगा या नहीं जिएगा. द गॉल ब्लैडर वॉज मच इन्वॉल्व्ड. ये डिटेल्स हैं उनकी हेल्थ की. देन The old man had begun to breathe deeply. Who is the old man? General Takima. And to demand food. But कुछ ही दिन बाद उसकी तबीयत अच्छी होने लगी General Takima की और उसने खाना मांगना शुरू करा. Sadao had not been able to ask about the assassins. Sadao नहीं पूछ पाया General Takima से कि भाई आप assassins भेजने वाले थे, क्या हुआ उनका? So far as he knew, they had never come. And so far as Sadao knew, and he's also right in thinking about it, that this man over here, okay, after having escaped, so let's say, you know, when he's saying that he escaped that particular night, and Sadao said that General Takima was under an operation, okay, so here we know that he was operated upon a week before, aur uske baad kya hua tha? The gallbladder was much involved, and The old man had begun to breathe deeply again and to demand food. Sadao had not been able to ask about the assassins at all. And he was right to think that the assassins had never come. Assassins aaye hi nahi the kabhi bhi. So, assassins had never come. That's the first condition. Okay. Two, Sadao had helped Tom to escape. Yes. And three, over here, the servants had returned. They had come back. Obviously, they would come back because now Tom has gone. Yumi had cleaned the guest room thoroughly. और यूमी ने गेस्ट रूम को खूब अच्छे से क्लीन करा and had burned sulfur. और उसने सल्फर जलाया उस कमरे में to get the white man's smell out of it. ताकि उस कमरे से उस white man की smell निकल जाए. Nobody said anything. और किसी ने कुछ नहीं कहा. आपस में servants ने ना कुछ कहा ना पूछा. कोई जिक्र नहीं हुआ कि Tom कहाँ चला गया, मर गया, भाग गया, पुलिस को दिया, आर्मी को दिया. कुछ नहीं, nothing at all. There was nothing said. Only the gardener was cross. Only the old gardener, he was slightly annoyed. Why? Because he had got behind with his chrysanthemums. Chrysanthemums are flowers. तो सिर्फ गार्डनर थोड़ा सा गुस्सा था क्योंकि वो थोड़ा सा लेट हो गया था अपने chrysanthemums लगाने में. There is a particular season to plant them. ठीक. And then within a month or so, these flowers would bloom, chrysanthemums, okay? But after a week, Sadao felt the general was well enough to be spoken about the prisoner. अब एक हफ्ते के बाद जब सदाओ को लगा कि भाई जनरल ठीक है, तो अब उसको लगा कि बात की जा सकती है जनरल से अबाउट द प्रिजनर. यस एक्सेलेंसी, ही एस्केप्ड. उसने कहा हाँ एक्सेलेंसी, वो भाग गया. सदाओ नाउ सेड, ही कफ्ड, सिग्निफाइंग दैट ही हैड नॉट सेड All he might have said, but was unwilling to disturb the general further. और उसने थोड़ा सा खांसा, because वो ज़्यादा disturb नहीं करना चाहता था general Takima को. तो बस उसने ये बोला कि His Excellency, that American prisoner of war, he escaped. But the old man opened his eyes suddenly. But एकदम से ये सुन के जो general Takima थे, उनकी आंखें खुल गईं. That prisoner, he said with some energy, did I not promise you I would kill him for you? और जब operation सब कुछ हो गया है, पूरा एक week हो गया है यहाँ पे, और अब क्या कहते हैं, General Takima is even recovering. तो वो यहाँ पे बोलते हैं, अरे हाँ वो prisoner, मैंने तो तुमसे बोला था कि मैं तुम्हें, मतलब he had promised, who had promised? General Takima, कि I will send somebody to kill him, कि मैं वहां पे किसी को भेजूंगा टू किल हिम फॉर यू. ओके, लेट्स टर्न द पेज. एंड सो हियर आई वुड लाइक टू वाइंड अप ओवर हियर इन टुडे सेशन. सो ही सेड दैट डिड आई नॉट प्रोमिस यू आई वुड किल हिम फॉर यू. हु हैड प्रोमिस्ड हुम? General Takima had promised Sadao, and the promise was about sending private assassins. But was this promise fulfilled? No. What happened? Yes, there was a lot of problem. And what was the problem? The assassins never came. The first night went. The second night went. The third night went. For three nights, Sadao waited के असैसिन्स आएंगे और टॉम को ले जाएंगे, उसको मारेंगे या कुछ करेंगे. एंड व्हेन नथिंग हैपेंड हियर सदाओ हेल्प्स टॉम टू एस्केप. दिस इज द एस्केप प्लान. ओके. एंड व्हाट वाज द एस्केप प्लान? द एस्केप प्लान वाज टू सेंड टॉम to that particular island which was not very far from the coast, and from that island Tom could catch or could wait for a Korean fishing boat. He could get onto the boat and he would be saved. And then there were these instructions given by Dr. Sadao regarding the flashlight. So all these things that were done before, and here we saw how Dr. Sadao dressed Tom so that he could not be instantly caught. So in typical Japanese clothes, and specially a black cloth over his head that would stop his, you know, his identity from getting revealed that he is a blonde. So my dear students, and then the surgery takes place, he has gone, okay, and everything is okay, the servants have come back, etc., etc. So in today's session we saw that Dr. Sadao helped Tom to escape. Okay, now if Dr. Sadao has helped Tom to escape, again, you know, we come back to the same question which I had been putting to you people right from the beginning, you know, of the chapter, patriotism versus humanity. What is happening here? Is Dr. Sadao right in doing so? Has he taken the correct step? Okay, and what happens? You know, is General Takima going to take an action against Sadao? So that's not happening, definitely. And has Tom gone? Everything is getting back to normal. So this is what we need to think about here while I am winding up today's session. So again, my dear children, see, it's very important for us to understand that Dr. Sadao is a patriot. He is a true nationalist, and he, whatever he has done for Tom, whatever he has done for that prisoner of war, has only been because of the oath that he has taken as a doctor. He is supposed to save lives. So though he is an enemy, what he does, is it right or wrong? This is what we need to find out. So by the next session, we will be able to, the next class basically, we will be able to complete the chapter, and then we will be taking the question answers of this chapter in detail, because here you see these 7-8 questions. They are slightly twisted and complicated, but then yes, if you have understood the story properly, you will be able to answer them. So in the meanwhile, please keep revising so that you may not forget what we have done, and in case if there is any doubt, feel free to contact me. Okay, take care, students.